हेलो एवरीवन, दिस इज धर्मवीर सर हियर। सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू कंटिन्यू विद चैप्टर 10 ऑफ ग्रेड 11 मैथ्स, विच इज स्ट्रेट लाइंस। एंड द टॉपिक ऑफ टुडेज वीडियो इज जनरल इक्वेशन ऑफ ए लाइन। इन द प्रीवियस वीडियो वी हैव लर्न अबाउट डिफरेंट फॉर्म्स ऑफ इक्वेशन ऑफ लाइन। नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू फाइंड जनरल इक्वेशन ऑफ अ लाइन। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट। नाउ फर्स्ट वी हैव द जनरल इक्वेशन ऑफ लाइन। So any equation of the form ax plus by plus c equals to 0, where a and b are simultaneously not 0, because b, that is a and b cannot be 0 together, is called a general equation of line. So if we have an equation of the form ax plus by plus c equals to 0, then it will be an equation of a line. Clear? So pause and note down this point. Next is different forms of ax plus by plus c equals 0. We have learned about slope intercept form. So if b is not equal to 0, then ax plus by plus c can be written as y equals to minus a upon bx plus minus c upon b, which is in the form of y is equal to mx plus c, or m is equal to what? Minus a upon b, and c is equal to minus c upon b. Clear? And if b is equal to 0, then x equals to minus c upon a, which is a vertical line whose slope is not defined, and x-intercept is minus c upon a. Clear? So pause and note down this point. Next we have intercept form. If c is not equal to 0, then ax plus by plus c can be written as x upon minus c upon a plus y upon minus c upon b equals to 1, which in the form of x upon a plus y upon b equals to 1, where a is equal to minus c upon a and b is equal to minus c upon b. Now if c is equal to 0, then ax plus by plus c equals to 0 can be written as ax plus by equals 0, which is a line passing through the origin and therefore has 0 intercepts on the axis. Clear? So pause and note down this point. Next is the normal form. The normal form of the equation ax plus by plus c is x cos omega plus y sin omega equals to p, where cos omega is equal to plus minus a upon under root a square plus b square, sin omega is equal to plus minus b upon under root a square plus b square, and p, the perpendicular distance, equals to plus minus c upon under root a square plus b square. Now we have to be very careful while taking the sine of p, because the p is always positive, because it was the perpendicular distance of the line. Clear? So pause and note down this point. Now, distance of a point from a line. So if we have a line L, ax plus by plus c equals to 0, and we have a point P, x1, y1, then the distance of the point from the line ax plus by plus c is given by d equals to modulus, because it is positive. So modulus ax1 plus by1 plus c upon under root a square plus b square, where x1, y1 is the point and ax plus by plus c equals to 0 is the line. Clear? So pause and note down this formula. Next we have distance between two parallel lines. So if we have two parallel lines, y is equal to mx plus c1 and y is equal to mx plus c2, then the distance between the parallel lines is given by d is equal to modulus c1 minus c2 upon under root 1 plus m square, where c1 and c2 are the constants and m was the slope of the line. Clear? So pause and note down this point. So keeping all these points in mind, let's start exercise 10.3. And the question 1 is, reduce the following equations into slope intercept form and find their slopes and the y intercepts. So I'm solving the second part for you, which is 6x plus 3y minus 5 equals to 0. Now this equation can be written as 3y is equal to minus 6x plus 5. So dividing by 3, we get y is equal to minus 2x plus 5 by 3. So comparing this with the slope intercept, that is y is equal to mx plus c, we get the slope m equals to minus 2 and the y intercept c is equal to 5 by 3. Clear? So pause and note down this solution. Next is question 2. reduce the following equations into intercept form and find their intercepts on the axis. So I've solved the first part for you, which is 3x plus 2y minus 12 equals to 0. So writing in the form, we get 3x plus 2y equals to 12. So dividing by 12 to make RHS 1, we get 3x upon 12 plus 2y upon 12 equals to 1. Or writing in the standard form, we get x upon 4 plus y upon 6 equals to 1. So comparing this with the slope intercept form, that is x upon a plus y upon b equals to 1, we get x intercept a is equal to 4 and y intercept b is equal to 6. Clear? So pause and note down the solution. Moving to question 3. Reduce the following equations into normal form. Find their perpendicular distance from the origin and angle between perpendicular and the positive x-axis. So I've solved the first part for you, which is x minus root 3y equals to minus 8. Okay, so since in the standard form the RHS is positive, so multiplying the entire equation of minus, we get minus x plus root 3y equals to minus equals to 8. So dividing by under root a square plus b square, that is under root minus 1 square plus root 3 square, we get 2. So it is minus 1 upon 2x plus root 3 upon 2y equals to 4. So comparing this with this normal form of equation, that is x cos omega plus y sin omega equals to p, we get cos omega is minus half, sin omega is root 3 by 2, and the perpendicular distance p is equal to 4. Now here cos omega is negative and sin omega is positive. It means omega lies in the second quadrant. So cos omega equals to minus cos 60. So we get omega is equal to 120 degree. So putting the value of p and omega in equation 1, we get x cos 120 plus y sin 120 equals to 4, which is the normal form, and the perpendicular distance p is equal to 4 and angle omega is equal to 120 degree. Clear? So pause and note down the solution. Next is question 5. Find the points on the x-axis whose distance from the line x upon 3 plus y upon 4 equals to 1 are 4 unit. Now let the coordinate of the required point on x-axis be x0. We know that y coordinate is 0 on x-axis. So the equation of the line is x upon 3 plus y upon 4 equals to 1. So converting this in the standard form, we get 4x plus 3y minus 12 equals to 0. Now the perpendicular distance of any point from a line is given by, I hope you remember the formula, ax1 plus by1 plus c upon under root a square plus b square. So here the point is x0 and line is 4x plus 3 minus 12. So, and it is also given that the perpendicular distance is 4. So using that, we get modulus 4x plus 3 into 0 minus 12 upon under root 4 square plus 3 square equals to 4. So simplifying this, we get 4x, modulus 4x minus 12 equals to 20. So 4x minus 12 equals to plus minus 20. Okay. Because x is a coordinate and it can be positive or negative. So solving, we have x minus 3 equals to plus minus 5. So or x equals to 3 plus minus 5. So we have two values of x, that is 8 and minus 2. So required point will be px0, it will be p80 or p minus 2 0. Clear? Pause and note down the solution. Moving to question 6. Find the distance between parallel lines. So I have solved the first part for you. 15x plus 8y minus 34 equals to 0 and 15x plus 8y plus 31 equals to 0. So here we have a is equal to 15, b is equal to 8 and c1 equals to minus 34 and c2 equals to 31. So using the formula of distance between parallel lines, that is d is equal to modulus c1 minus c2 upon under root a square plus b square, we get modulus minus 34 minus 31 upon under root 15 square plus 8 square, which is minus modulus minus 65 upon 289 under 289. So distance will be 65 upon 17. Clear? So pause and note down the solution. Moving to question 8. Find the equation of the line perpendicular to the line x minus 7y plus 5 and having x intercept equals to 3. Now the given line is x minus 7y plus 5. So we can find its slope. Slope is equal to what? Minus of 1 upon minus 7 equals to 1 upon 7. So required line is perpendicular to the given line. So its slope will be negative inverse. So the slope of the required line is minus 7. So it has x intercept 3. So it is passing through the point 3, 0. So equation of the line with slope minus 7 and passing through 3, 0 will be y minus 0 equals to minus 7 into x minus 3. We have used the point slope form. So we have the equation y minus 7x plus 21, or writing in the standard form, we get 7x plus y equals to 21. So this is the required equation. Clear? So pause and note down the solution. Moving to question 10, the line through the point h3 and 4 1 intersect the line 7x minus 9y minus 19 equals to 0 at right angle. Find the value of h. Now we know that the slope of the line passing through two points h3 and 4 1 will be m1 equals to 1 minus 3 upon 4 minus h, that is minus 2 upon 4 minus h, and the slope of the line, that is 7x minus 9y minus 19 equals to 0, will be m2 equals to what? 7 upon 9. Now it is given that both the lines are perpendicular, so their product of slopes will be equals to minus 1. So putting the value of slopes, minus 2 upon 4 minus h multiplied by 7 upon 9 equals to 1. So simplifying, we are getting h equals to 22 upon 9, which are the required value. Clear? So pause and note down the solution. Moving to question 13. Find the equation of the line, equation of the right bisector of the line segment joining the point 3, 4 and minus 1, 2. So we have the point A, 3, 4 and point B equals to minus 1, 2. You can see in the figure. It is the line L is the perpendicular and bisector. Okay. So M will be what? The midpoint. This point is the midpoint because it is given that L is the bisector. So midpoint of AB, using midpoint formula, we get m equals to 3 minus 1 upon 2 and 4 plus 2 upon 2, which is 1, 3. Now the right bisector of AB is the line L through M and perpendicular to AB. Now slope of AB is what? Using the slope formula, slope of AB is 2 minus 4 upon minus 1 minus 3, that is 1 upon 2. Now it is given that the lines are perpendicular. So the slope of L will be negative inverse of AB. So slope of L equals to what? Minus 2. So equation of the right bisector line L is y minus 3 equals to minus 2 into x minus 1, and simplifying we get 2x plus y equals to 5. So this is the required equation of the line L. Clear? So pause and note down the solution. Next we have question 18. If P is the length of perpendicular from the origin to the line whose intercepts on the axis are A and B, then show that 1 upon p square equals to 1 upon a square plus 1 upon b square. Now we know that the equation of line whose intercepts on the axis are a and b is x upon a plus y upon b equals to 1, or it can be written as x upon a plus y upon b minus 1 equals to 0. Now using the distance formula, the distance of any point from any point, here the point is origin, from any line, and the line is x upon a plus y upon b minus 1 equals 0, is given by this one. You remember the formula, modulus ax1 plus by1 plus c1 upon under root a square plus b square. So p is equal to modulus 0 plus 0 minus 1 upon under root 1 upon a square plus 1 upon b square modulus. So negative is gone, so we get p is equal to 1 upon under root 1 upon a square plus 1 upon b square. So squaring both sides, p square is 1 upon 1 upon a square plus 1 upon b square, and cross multiplying we will get 1 upon a square plus 1 upon b square equals to 1 upon p square. So this is our required proof. Clear? So pause and note down the solution. With this, we end the exercise 10.3. So solve the remaining sums and don't forget to solve the examples given before the exercise. Okay, so thank you and all the best.